You're tuning into Black and White Sports on YouTube. The no-holds-barred truth on sports. The main event starts now.
I am back. Rudrants for Black and White Sports 2. Well, let's talk about Lamar Jackson. I've got a couple of different things. I've got something related to Trey Lance and Lamar Jackson. And then we've got something related to Deshaun Watson. And we know how Deshaun Watson and Lamar Jackson's situation correlates together, and the fact that Lamar wanted Deshaun's contract only better. He wanted a bigger number, and he wants a bigger, fully guaranteed number than what Deshaun Watson got. He wanted a fully guaranteed contract, and the NFL owners have been very vocal without being vocal about the fact that, look, Lamar, that was an outlier. Okay, that was Jimmy Haslam and the train wreck Browns being desperate. So they gave Deshaun Watson, a guy with 25 civil lawsuits, $230 million fully guaranteed. The quarterback market has since course corrected, since reset. I think we're somewhere in the neighborhood of, after Jalen Hurts the other day, about 7 or 8 new contracts since Deshaun Watson. So that should, in theory, speak volumes about where we are and where Lamar should be. Again, he needs an agent. And that in itself is not sitting well with owners either. It just makes the process complicated. You know, when you're talking about this much money, they don't want to negotiate with mama. You know, and who could blame them? I mean, really? And you can't be objective about the quarterback and somebody not get their feelings hurt, especially if mama is involved, right? Mama's gonna get mad. Well, they don't want to work with mama when they're talking about $250 million, and I don't blame them, right? So combine that with all the stuff involving him missing games at the end of the year, rampant speculation, I should add, about the fact that a lot of people thought he could play at the end of the year, the last two games, and that's league-wide. It's a bad look. So, since he wants Deshaun Watson's money, it only makes sense that Deshaun Watson has come out and talked about Lamar Jackson's contract situation? Question mark? What? We've also got a story related out of SI involving the Ravens and Trey Lance. Wait, what? We want to acquire a quarterback that is actually slower than Lamar Jackson and actually throws the ball way worse than our current running quarterback. I'm going to keep it real here. I'm a 49ers fan, so I would know, okay? I've seen every single solitary snap in an actual game, preseason or real game, that Trey Lance has ever taken. Tyler Huntley is a better quarterback than Trey Lance. There we go. They just re-signed him. Why the bleep would they want to go get Trey Lance? My God. It's weird. And somehow, some way, this article believes that getting Trey Lance would put pressure on Lamar Jackson, or the threat of getting Trey Lance. Nah, you got to threaten to get somebody that could actually replace him. Let the word get out that they're about to trade for Kirk Cousins. Then you've got a situation, okay? An actual quarterback. Wait a minute. Now the Ravens they've entered the chat on Aaron Rodgers. Now you've got real pressure on Lamar Jackson to step in and sign his non-exclusive franchise tag. Deshaun Watson is a polarizing player, not only due to all the issues off the field, but his contract as well. This is dogpounddaily.com. Looks like all things Cleveland Browns. When the Cleveland Browns traded for Watson, they quickly gave him a new deal worth $230 million over 5 seasons. It's all fully guaranteed. Worst, and this is the other thing. Hey, Lamar, this is viewed as the worst contract in sports, possibly. Literally. I kid you not. While that average per year has since been top, no one else has been given guarantees like he had. That has been a point of contention for those who like to defend the poor billionaires who are being bullied into protecting players who play a dangerous sport. But others have paid attention as well, including Lamar Jackson. Jackson, who is his own agent, is in a standoff with the Ravens over his contract. They made some offers, but he saw Watson's guarantee and he wants that for himself. To date, Watson has stayed rather quiet, but has spoken up. Quote, from the outside looking in, I hope he gets what he wants. Like I said, I never talked to him about it, so I can't speak on his business side. But he's a great player, and he's going to be, if he's back in Baltimore, he's going to be special for them. And if it's somewhere else, he's going to be special for that organization. So, are you going to be special for the Browns, Deshaun? I would wonder. The truth is twofold. One, Watson only got the guarantee because he was being courted by several teams, whereas Jackson has solely been negotiating with the Ravens thus far. There's nobody else to bid against. That's the thing, you know. I mean, they've got it out there where any team could jump right in. They haven't. If he wants to see that guaranteed amount increase, he needs another bidder. Two, the argument over guaranteed deals is maddening. The NBA and MLB offer fully guaranteed contracts, and you don't have near as many risk of serious injury as the NFL players do. Yet the idea of actually protecting these guys financially from such an injury has turned into blasphemy. Yeah, and buddy, it's going to continue to be blasphemy. So there's that, all right? Just on a side note to all of this, I'm just letting you know this story came out. It's also of SI. And, of course, I just said Tyler Huntley re-signed that restricted free agent tender. But the Baltimore Ravens are going to look at quarterbacks in the draft. By the way, the draft is Thursday. The draft is Thursday. Some people are talking about Hendon Hooker. I like Hendon Hooker a ton coming out of this draft. A lot. Okay? Played in a lot of games, a lot more experience than somebody like Anthony Richardson's got. Honestly, I like him more than Will Levis, to be honest with you. But he's coming off of an injury. He would probably miss this next season. And he's already 25 years old. He would be 26. That's considered old. That said, the Ravens are staring at another quarterback that is also 25 and has also played a lot and, by the way, won two national championships. Georgia's Stetson Bennett. That's right. He would probably be there on day three. He wouldn't cost them any money. And the new offensive coordinator of the Ravens happens to be Todd Monken. Now, you might be like, what does that matter? It was Stetson Bennett's offensive coordinator with the University of Georgia. There you go. Now, let's get to a Steelers insider that works for The Athletic because he believes there's another component here, like several people have talked about. He thinks Lamar might set out the season. I think that is disastrous. It's the worst idea ever. Because I'm not sure he gets back in the league if he sets out, to be honest with you. Yet another NFL insider has suggested that the Baltimore Ravens quarterback Lamar Jackson could sit out games during the 2023-24 season while on the non-exclusive franchise tag. For a piece published Friday, Steelers reporter Mark Caboli of The Athletic predicted that Jackson, quote, will stay out until he has to come in to accrue another season and thus making the franchise tag unusable next season. Added Caboli, I see this being a potential disaster for the Ravens if he holds out into the season, and I am talking about more than just wins and losses. Can the Ravens not win as many games with Tyler Huntley? I wonder about that because they almost beat the Bengals. I mean, inches away from beating the Bengals. I don't know. I mean, I'm not arguing the fact that Lamar Jackson is a better quarterback. I know that. But the way that team is coached, the way they play the game, they're in almost every game. It's John Harbaugh. You just have to wonder. I mean, honestly. Caboli's colleague at The Athletic, oh, the great Mike Sandow, explained that players must report for at least 6 games to get credit for a season. Otherwise, their contracts toll, and they would move no closer to free agency. Sandow also noted in Caboli's scenario, Baltimore could retain Jackson's rights for 2024 via the franchise tag at 1.2 times his salary at 2023, or as yet unknown value of tag, whichever would be greater. And Sandow does believe that he will ultimately play under the franchise tag. I do too. Dan Orlovsky, Jason Lockenfora, Peter King, Mike Florio have all floated the idea that he may set out. So that's certainly interesting. I still don't think he'll set out. And then there's this. Then there's this involving Trey Lance. This is also from SI. The 49ers, per NFL Network's Ian Rapoport, are willing to listen to offers for 49ers quarterback Trey Lance. How does this concern Baltimore? If the Ravens genuinely believe that the contract situation isn't going to resolve itself with Jackson, then a trade for Lance could make sense. Even ESPN has put forth a potential trade package that would send Lance and Jackson to opposite teams. Wait a minute now. Okay. Let's see this trade package. I'm scrolling down. ESPN's Bill Barwell, blah, blah, blah. I want to see the package. Where is it? Okay, so they're talking about, I guess, Trey Lance for and a second-round pick. Get creative. Trey Lance, Brandon Ayuk, a 2024 for Jackson and a fourth-round pick. Nah, you can forget that. I can tell you right now. No way am I trading Trey. They can have Trey Lance for ham sandwich, and that's fine. But Brandon Ayuk and a first-round pick? Are you mental for Lamar Jackson? And a fourth round, a candy ass, throw in at the back end, 2024 fourth round pick. No, they can keep Lamar Jackson. And I can tell you right now, the one thing we haven't talked about as far as the Niners and Lamar, because you notice I haven't brought that up really and truly, even as a 49ers fan. I don't think Kyle Shanahan has ever been in on a dual threat quarterback. I understand Mike Shanahan and Kyle lock in step with the Redskins drafted RG3. Three rounds later took Kirk Cousins. They didn't believe in RG3. They didn't. Okay? Not in their offense. And the one thing I do know as a Niners fan, Kyle Shanahan's not changing his offense. He's not. Why and why would he? Question mark. It works, for crying out loud. So I think you can just scrub that. I mean, maybe Trey Lance, you could send him over there and have him on the roster, and maybe a person could construe that as putting pressure on Lamar Jackson. But Trey Lance has done nothing. He's done nothing except show that he looks like a monumental bust. Okay? An all-time bust. So, I don't know. You still got Trey Lance fans out there that believe he's never gotten a chance and yada, yada, yada. Look, John Lynch and Kyle Shanahan has watched, consumed, and coached and played in more football than anybody that will come through this channel outside of people involved in the league have ever consumed. If they don't think he can do it, the something's not right there, right? I mean, something's not right with the pick. Trey Lance was just a miss. It is what it is. If they thought they had a quarterback that could ball out, they wouldn't have had Rapoport put those rumors out. They want to trade Trey Lance. preferably before the draft, so they can get some draft picks or draft pick for this draft. So, you know, there's that. Anyway, so there we have it. We got Deshaun Watson making a comment. We got Trey Lance involved. We got the idea of Lamar Jackson once again setting out for the whole season, and I think it's a horrible idea. Here's what I think's going to happen. I'm going to predict this, okay? I've said I think he ends up going back to the Ravens. I thought he would end up playing on the franchise, the non-exclusive franchise tag. I think that's still very, very possible. But I do believe what may happen is they're going to present the same deal that they offered him later on last year, like in September, October, the deal that Schefter and Mortensen said that they've seen with their own eyes. They confirmed it. And I'm talking about the $200 million deal with $179 in total guarantees and $133 due at signing. Okay, that one, 3 years, $133. It was a longer contract than that. And I think they're just going to hand him that contract, and they're going to add about $20 million to it somewhere, okay? I would assume they would hand it to him in the fully guaranteed area and get the fully guaranteed area up to $200 million, and I think he's going to take it. That's my guess. Essentially the same contract with about $20 million added somewhere. Now, one could argue, do you want to pay that much for Lamar? That's the other question, and we could spend all day debating that. I could go live, and we could just go back and forth in the chat over whether or not Lamar is, because I like Lamar, actually. I think he's the best dual threat quarterback we've seen come out in a very, very long time, and I think he can pass better than most people give him credit for. $200 or $210 million in guarantees. Good? That's where I tend to have the hold up. And obviously, that's where the Ravens got the hold up too. Right? Tell me what you think. Peace. I'm out. Till next time.
Thanks for watching the show. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. Be sure to tune in next time on Black and White Sports.